Okay, so we're going to replace this worn out GFI here. Dirty ketchup up there. And this one had tails on the back. We pigtailed your wires in, and they just cut them off and taped the ends off, so that would have been live sticking out there all that time. And let's see how they did hooking up this one here with this wire nut. There's the strands. See how even they were. It wasn't all that bad. Let's see how we did on the back wires. Okay, that was fair. Again, they used orange for the ground. So I'll take this box off so I can do a better job making the connections, and I'll put the box back on after we're done. So we have a black feed through going to the light. So we'll twist our stranded wires together here. We have our white wires, but they're not very even, as you can see. So I'm going to untwist those. Bad, so I'm going to twist them back together nice and tight here. I'll clip the ends so that they're even here at the end. And I'll clip my tail off to go to the GFI. Start with our white wire. We'll use our 14 gauge hole here. We'll use a red wire nut. We'll get our wires even like that deep there. So there's our white wire, and here's our black wire that's going to go to the GFI. And we have our orange wires they're using as a ground. Normally use a green or a bare wire for the ground. So we will get the insulation lined up there at the bottom. We'll twist them together so they're even here. Off so it's even at the bottom here. nice and tight. And now we have our black, our white, and our ground to go to the GFI. I'll clip just a little off of this strand of wire here so they're even. We're going to use the Lee Grand version of the GFI. Okay, so we will see where it says load and line. We're not going to be using the load, so we'll close those two terminals in. And as you can see, it has the pressure plate connections here. I like this idea. Okay, so we will put the black on the brass side here. Okay, that's a little too long, so we're going to clip some more of that off. That's still a little long, so I'll put a little more on. Okay, right there is what we want. Silver colored side. We'll put the ground under the green screw and make sure it's under the pressure plate all the way there. Make sure it's tight. Then we'll come over here and we'll get our black wire on the brass side. We'll make sure it's the right length. Open up our pressure plate there. Get our wires under there like that. Make sure it's nice and tight like that. Make sure all the dirt is out of there. Now we can put our box back on the wall here. Tricky getting the screws lined up with the holes inside there. One, two. So now we're ready to screw our GFI into the box. Use the cover. Didn't come with any screws, so we'll have to go take screws out of something. Okay, well, we got some screws out of something else, and we'll push this into the wall here. We'll keep our ground wire up at this end of the box so it doesn't touch anything we don't want it to touch. Keeping the bag away from everything, and we'll sit right in here nice and easily without forcing it on anything. And that is how to replace a GFCI piece. Thanks for watching.